Okay, we're back. I hope you enjoyed that interview. It was really fun to kind of get some last minute like talking to her while we were together. I miss her terribly. So the next part we were going to talk about is how I feel coming back, how I have felt the past couple of months. So initially when I came back, I was trying my hardest actually to not be one of those like kids where it's like, I've gotten some of them on TikTok where it's like memes about the stereotypical kid who came back from study abroad and it's like, oh my gosh, we did that. Oh my gosh, I did that while I was over there. Oh, this is nothing compared to the food, da da da, that I ate in like, you know, it's like in Italy or whatever. So I was trying really hard not to be like that, especially because I feel like I wouldn't have gotten made fun of it, but people would have definitely gotten frustrated with me about it. And I just didn't want that to happen, just for that to be the only thing I talk about, even though it is such a big life experience. So that's something that is kind of lame, but there's not much you can do about it because you just don't want it to feel like you're rubbing it into other people's faces, like, oh, I went on study abroad, because not everybody gets that opportunity and it can be expensive and there's a lot of things that go into it. However, coming back, I was at the point where I had started to feel comfortable in Japan. I was starting to understand what people were saying, even though I didn't know very much Japanese. A lot of things like that. And so I kind of feel like I was pulled out right as I was starting to get good with it. And that was also kind of lame. But I was happy to come back and see my friends and my family and stuff like that and be able to share what I did learn without forgetting anything because I wasn't there for too long. So that's a good thing. I do try to message my host family at least once a month or once every other week because I want to keep in touch with them, but not so much that it's like every day like, hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing? And they're like, oh my God, we never should have hosted you. So I do keep in touch with them. And then I think what I miss the most, at least right now, like, at first, it was kind of, like, my host family and also just kind of life in general over there. Right now, I kind of miss my America friends, like Ash and Brian and Mario. I mean, obviously, I miss my host family a ton, and I think every once in a while, like, oh, I should have done this or, oh, I should have done that. And I hate that I think that because it was such a good experience. I just like, it's just human nature. It's just devil's advocate. But I miss Ash and Brian and Mario because they're the people who are like, they know they had very similar experiences to you out of like the hundreds of people you talk to. Those are the 35, the 34 who really understand what you did. And those three were obviously who understood it more than the others. Because Ash and Brian, I mean, we were all in the same city and we saw each other all the time. And then Mario and I are just close. So that's kind of what I'm going through right now. I know a lot of the other YFU kids, like, we still talk in the group chat every once in a while. And a lot of them are trying to do study abroad in Japan as soon as possible. So some of them are trying to go for, like, next summer. Or some of them are trying to do it in college if they're too old and stuff like that. So I think we're all kind of just missing it, but we're able to carry on with our lives. And it's just like a fond memory to look back on, but it felt like a short time, which it was. But I am so, do not get me wrong, I am so incredibly glad I got to go. It's such a beautiful memory for me. It's just like, oh, I miss it. But it's okay, because the missing it really isn't too bad after the first, like, month and a half, month or two. Even though it's just something that lives in the back of your mind, like a brick in your pocket. And you forget about it every once in a while, but there it is. But it's okay. And now, here's gonna be... But I'm gonna start off with, like, my actual stuff pile. So I have, which we've probably already seen throughout my vlogs, but my Kurobe socks. I love them. They're so nice. I have, which we've definitely seen throughout my vlogs multiple times, my unique yellow sweater. So nice. I'm going to wear it to school tomorrow. I'm not ready to go to school tomorrow. So with like some of the candy, they'll have prizes. So there was like BTS and BT21 like gummy packs, and they came with keychains. So here's the one I got with my BTS gummies. It's RM in his butter costume. It's actually really nice. He looks a little dorky. It's supposed to be the tiny tans, but I feel like he still looks a little off. Here's the one I got from my BT21 gummies. I actually love the fact that like it's pastel and the background part is like not fully clear, but it's not like yellow like the butter one. It's so cute. Look at them. RJ's working out and Jimmy's just like, oop, gonna be Jimmy. Gonna be Jimin. Also, if you hear Turbo meowing in the background, that's how she is. I might go get her, but I know she's gonna come in here and try and fight everything, and it'll make it take longer. So this is my I can't say Uniqlo. It was from GU, which is the sister brand of Uniqlo, but my earrings was my pencil bag I got from the Pokemon Center. From Kayano, this was my little Tay-Tay. Look at him, he's so cute. And then this is my final gift from my host mom and stuff, so I will get that out. Oh, so this bag ended up being, she knitted a muffler for Mr. Pickles. I haven't put it on him yet, but once I do, insert picture here. This was my letter, which we're not gonna like read on here. That just feels wrong. But she did also give me like a little Dharma notebook. It's actually really cute, and it's like got really nice Japanese paper in it. It's like the paper is different. It's so nice. That goes right there. And then for some reason, I only have one, but I know I brought both of them back from the restaurant last night, but my chopsticks from home. Here's the one. Good stuff. My other present from my host mom is this claw clip I've been wearing. I wore it yesterday, I wore it today. Technically, I wore it the day before. And then Kayano has the like matching like pinky. But I'm gonna wrap people's gifts that I got them in my bags from Japan, so it's like, you know, kind of cool. Because like, whatever. Cause I got my dad like a little Shinkansen model engine thing for the front of it. And my host family gave him a Mazda calendar. And then for my mom, I got her like the little Disney bell ring set and some candy and whatnot. And for Brie, I got her the little Pokemon bonsai thing. For Will, I got him the Pokemon bottle thing, which he actually loved, and I was very happy about that. And then Logan, I got him like the Rowlet plushie and the New Year's envelope, the Pikachu and Eevee New Year's envelope. And then Jess, I got her a bunch of stuff. I got her like a little cinema roll Gachapon keychain, yeah, and he was in a little teacup. And then she and I have some tea that we're gonna share, but I still have that. And I got her Sprigatito washi tape, and I got her Kirby gummies, and there was so much more I could have bought her there, but I didn't, which is probably for the best. These two next things are for my paw, because he has like his lunchbox and stuff, and I wanted to make him feel like a cool Japanese kid or whatever. So I got him these mystery pins from Miyajima. This samurai helmet one. And Mount Fuji. Mount Fuji was actually
really cool that I got that one out of like all the ones in there. So
nextly, I got these fuzzy socks from the Pokemon Center for Maddie because she carried around like this. Oh, this Pokemon card that she got from like the, you know, when you got a couple years ago, aka a couple years ago, like last spring. There was the cereal boxes you could get, and it would have, like, a Pokemon card or two in there. So she ended up getting a sheep, and she chose sheeps, so it turned out perfectly. But this was the sheep that she would carry around in the back of her phone on that Pokemon card. And they're fuzzy socks, so one's, like, got this face, and the other one actually has their eyes open, and it's so cute, and they're so soft. And I got Haley these Pikachu hair clips, because she has curtain bangs, so she's always, like, pinning it back. And so I figured, like, oh, Pikachu, she's gonna love it. So this I got from Miss Hobbs. I don't know, I saw it and I just felt like it had, like, her soul in it. And it's a little rabbit figure. It was a mystery as well. There were, like, four other ones you could get. I was really hoping she would get a pink one. There were two pink ones. And she did, and it's sitting down, and it's so cute. Hold up. It's so cute. This I got from my Gigi. It's like the rice paddle thing from Miyajima. You can find them like everywhere, but this one has the deer and the Itsukushima shrine and the maple leaves and the mountains and Mount Misen specifically and the five-story pagoda there. And it's a little keychain as well. I got this for Coach Hobbs. I felt like it was the perfect project or perfect present because he is a world history teacher and he does teach about like the Japanese samurai and stuff. Alas, I didn't get to learn much about that, but it's another one of the good luck charms. This one's like good luck for work, but got that Hiroshima castle. This is for Steven. It's the wooden rice paddle. It's another one, like another keychain from Miyajima, but I know he would think it's funny. One, because he would like it because it's like actually like cultural and historical and stuff. But also because knowing Steven's brain and Dominic's brain, they're gonna laugh at it and be like, haha, it's like, and then I'm not gonna open these up, but these are two of the my two postcards I got from the Tokyo Disney store. So if you wanna see those, go check out that video where I go shopping like at the mall and stuff. Next time we move on to food, I got these Pokemon Eevee cup noodles. They also had Pikachu ones, but I like these, and they had mystery Eeveelution stickers in them, and like the little fish cake part is shaped like Eevee. I got a lot of food. Calbee, I love Calbee now. Calbee's like a Hiroshima company, and of course I had to get some before I left. I had another bag of chips, but I ate it before I got on my plane. I'm not mad about it. Those were good chips. But these are honey and butter potato chips. There also is salt, but it's honey butter potato chips from Calbee. I have these matcha Kit Kats. I am not going to eat them. I might eat one, but this is mainly for my culinary class as well. I got two of these I got because Kayano and I ate them, and so they're really special to me, and they look like bamboo shoots, which I think are cute. It's the same brand that does the chocolate shoot, the chocolate mushrooms. They taste really similar, a bit more chocolatey, you know, so you can kind of guess what they taste like, but they look like bamboo shoots and I love them. They're so cute. I got peach Kit Kat at the I actually found it at the airport yesterday. So anytime you can't find, because I had a hard time finding like specialty Kit Kats, don't give up hope, because I found like the only ones I found before I left Hiroshima was the matcha ones, because everything else they had was like chocolate, dark chocolate, or white chocolate, which we have in America. So I was like, okay, that's not worth it. So I bought the matcha ones thinking it was my only hope. And then we went to the airport and they had so many specialty ones. And they're the same price as they would have been anywhere else. So that was a good thing about the airport, is pretty much any food item is the same as it would have been anywhere else. Maybe the like the meals were upcharged a little, but it really wasn't bad. This was still like $3. Those were like, those matcha ones were $3. So
If you cannot find Kit Kats before you leave, you'll find them at the airport. At least at Haneda. Then this container is my envelopes from my like New Year's stuff. And then all of my like good luck fortunes and stuff. And my Miyajima thing. So I guess like the really only thing in here I have to show off is my Leafy On sticker that I'm going to put on my Hydro Flask. This is the Sanjo Spirit. Sanjo Jogaku Win. But this is like a little keepsake is what they told me, and it's all in Japanese, so I can't read it. But this side is like a guide for the middle school and what they do, and this side's a guide for the high school and what they do, and it shows like the winter and summer uniforms for both. It's actually really cool. It's really, really pretty and well made, but I don't know what to do with it. And this was my school journal, and like the middle school girls put their cat stickers on it, so it's really cute, but it's a mess. Because I just glued a bunch of my stuff in there because I know what to do with it. This is the last thing I have to show you, actually. Which I guess that's a good thing I saved this for the end. So if you remember when we did the tea ceremony, I was doing calligraphy and I was really, really struggling with it. But I finally successfully did it. And so this was like the final version. This was a big deal because this is like a canvas for that, for Japanese calligraphy. So I finally got a hold of it, or the hang of it, and so my special word for this trip was egao. I think that's how you're supposed to say it, and it means smile in Japanese, and that's like what Ms. Hobbs put on my bracelet, and she told me like, even though you can't speak Japanese and you can't read it, the universal language is to smile, and then my host family asked what my bracelet meant, and I told them, and they got really like sentimental about that as well. So that's the word that I put on my calligraphy. But it took so long and it was such a battle. But so this is egao in not katakana, in kanji. Yeah, this is egao in kanji, and then this is my name in katakana. But it looks really bad flipped like this, but this is really, really special to me. So.